A TSBVI outreach tutorial. APH Graphic Aid for Mathematics, aka Graph Board. Part 7, Graphing the Quadratic, Parabola, Y equals X squared, and Y equals negative X squared. Presented by Susan Osterhaus, a Texas School for the Blind, and Visually Impaired Outreach Math Consultant.
Okay, I've cleared the graph board except for the X and Y axes that we have. Again, the Y axes and the X axes are just rubber bands hooked down with thumbtacks. And we have the first, second, third, and fourth quadrant. We're going to move on from straight lines to graphing quadratics. These are sometimes called parabolas, and I'm going to graph a very simple one, Y equals X squared. Now, normally we would go ahead and have a T-table for this particular type of graphic, and we'll just start simple though, because I'm going to try to remember this in my head. Maybe we'll put something up online for you. Y equals X squared, I always tell the students, let's start with my favorite number, X value, which is zero, and it looks like an O kind of for Miss O, so that's why we're going to start with X equals zero. Well, if X is zero and Y is X squared is zero, so truthfully, our first point is 0, 0. So I'm going to take the thumbtack out just so that we remember it's not the origin, just the origin anymore. It's now actually a part of this graph. So we've got one point at 0, 0. And then we've already talked, we're going to pretend we've already talked about parabolas and so forth. So the students are going to already know what probably they should pick next. They're going to go ahead and let X be 1. Because it's the first integer, positive integer after zero. So if we plug in 1 for X, we get Y equals X squared, or Y equals 1 squared, which is 1. So now we have 1, 1. Boy, this is simple. All right. Then we're going to go ahead and go with negative 1. Negative 1 squared is positive 1. So we've gone ahead and graphed that point. And then, of course, they're going to try for 2. If X is 2, 2 squared is 4, so we're going to go 2 to the right and 1, 2, 3, 4 up. And by this time, hopefully your students have figured out, you know, I don't even need to do that because I've already figured out that these points are symmetric with regard to the y-axis, so I know there's another point that's just right there. And then they might pick 3. 3 squared is 9. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. Your push pin in there. And again, rather than going all the way down here and starting over again, the clever ones just go like this. And then they might say, uh-oh, are we going to have room for another one or not? Let's try X equals 4. 4 squared is 16. Well, let's find out. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. Oh, do we need to? Actually, if this is 4, we know this is 9. They start getting very clever and fast at this. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Whew! Did Miss O luck out? Okay, we got it up there. And again, we're going to come over here. Now, if you're very, very talented at this, let's see if I'm talented or not today, we're going to ask your students to go ahead and connect the dots. I'm going to put one rubber band going that direction. And notice these are the rubber bands where I've made them longer by knotting two together. And we now have the graph of the parabola y equals x squared. Now at this point we could have used, if you wanted to, you could have used the wires that come with this. And I'm going to reach over and get a wire. So some people might prefer using the wire, but I kind of like it like that. I think we graphed enough points that it's relatively rounded or curved there. So we've graphed y equals x squared, but again, if you needed to, you could use the wires, or you could use yarn or anything else if you felt like you really wanted to emphasize the fact that this is going around that vertex and coming back up in very nice curve. Now, what I love to do, this is my favorite thing, is I have the students graph this, and you probably, if you timing me, you figured out how long it took me to do that. And I have students, you know, working on this when I have other people observing. And then I sound like I'm very mean because I say, okay, that took you maybe a minute or 2 minutes, and now you have 2 seconds to graph y equals negative x squared. And anybody who's observing just gasps and say, how could she be so mean? And guess what my students do? As I mentioned, this is y equals x squared, and I ask them to graph y equals negative x squared. There, 2 seconds. All they had to do was turn it upside down. And they think they're pretty clever, and they like to show that off. And what they're learning here is that when you have a negative in front of the x squared portion, that you now have a parabola opening downward. When it's positive, y equals x squared, there's no positive there, but it would open upward. But they learn that really quickly, and they love showing that off. Then if you want to get into talking about parent functions, you can have something like y equals x squared minus 10, and that will drop this. You will have the same parabola, but the same shape, but it will be 10 units down. Or if you do y equals x squared plus 2, it would bring it up 2 units. The vertex would come up 2 units. Anyway, you can do all kinds of neat things, again, manually graphing, and the students really get it when they're actually having to move points through space and their hands. Very good for fine motor skills. A lot of times I have students that have that type of problem. Again, this really helps in that way as well. Orientation mobility instructors always come talk to me if their student is having a problem, because they know my students will be having similar problems. Again, graphing and graphing parabolas and all types of other things. Wonderful. Graph, graph, graph. That's my motto. Again, this is a quadratic, and all of the quadratics are going to have a shape like this, and it will either move down or up, or it'll move this way or that way. But basically, it's still going to have the same shape, and so your students can graph it similar to this.
This video continues in the TSBVI Outreach Tutorial Series, APH Graphic Aid for Mathematics. Look for other videos by Susan Osterhaus on Math for the Blind and Visually Impaired. APH is American Printing House for the Blind. A TSBVI Outreach Distance Learning Production. Executive Producers, William Daugherty, Superintendent. Cyril Miller, Outreach Director. Outreach Producers, Susan Osterhaus, Math Consultant. Mike Bicknell, Media Specialist. Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Programs. 1100 West 45th Street, Austin, Texas 78756 USA. Telephone 512-454-8631. Website www.tsbvi.edu. Video copyright TSBVI 2009. All rights reserved.